Hello there, welcome to this beginner tutorial for Pinnacle Studio 17. Check the Smart Index in video description to find fast what you're looking for. Pinnacle Studio is a professional video editing software to make videos, slideshows, or add video effects on clips. There are three main sections listed on top: Organize, Edit and Author. Author is used to make interactive introductions for CDs and DVDs. We will see it in another video. The workspace you need to know is the Edit one, where you create your video project. Let's see it. On top, on the left, you have the navigation panel that fully lists all the files imported and plus all Pinnacle Studio has to offer, such as effects or transitions. More on the right, you have the preview, showing how your project is going on. At the bottom, there is the timeline, where you will work and create your video project. Let's start with the basics. To create a new project, go to File in the top left corner and then to Movie. To start working, you need to import files in your timeline using the navigation panel first. This lists all the files and tools available in Pinnacle Studio. To see its full content, hover the hidden pin symbol. Each main section has its own color, indicating a different content. Blue is for media, with all the files imported in Pinnacle Studio. Violet for full projects saved and done under projects. Green for personalized groups of files inside collections. Yellow for advanced tools, including effects and transitions inside content. When you click on a section, this will become orange and will be opened on the right. So if you need to see all the imported files, just click on Media. Use the bar in the right corner to set the zoom, so to enlarge the files if you need. The Organize workspace on top is the same navigation panel covering the whole software window. Inside Media, the files are collected according to their source folder. If you want to create custom groups of files, you may need to use the Collections section. The navigation panel also contains files already imported. In case you want to import a new file, you can use Import in the top right corner and browse your computer, any CD or webcam. Then just check the files to import. Otherwise, you can simply click and drag the file to your navigation panel and this will be added there. Just after this step, you can click and drag a file to your timeline and start working on it. You can use the preview on the right to see how your file looks like. At the bottom you have the player to play, pause and stop, the speed rate to play faster or in reverse. Just make sure to be in source mode in this case. Use the playhead to see the file in a determined instant. You can make it loop, enabling the loop play button. You can add sound files in two other ways. On top of the timeline, you have a G-clef symbol, used to open the score fitter window. Through this, you can add more songs made available by Pinnacle Studio. Or, if you need to record sound or your voice, Click on the voice-over icon. Let's see the timeline. You have different rows called AV tracks used to welcome your files. You may have a voice-over track too, but this works exactly like a normal track and just named differently to isolate your recorded voice or sound. Basically, you have two main kinds of files here: the sound clips in a dark yellow color and the video clips indicated with a blue color that include videos and images. Video clips are shown with the respective video frames on top and any sound waveform more at the bottom. The pieces of text are video clips too, with the only difference that these are in green color and not in blue. Pieces of text, images and videos that don't have sound don't have any waveform in the bottom half. Sound files will just have the waveform instead. The preview is used to see how your project is going on. In this case, make sure to be in timeline mode to see how all the clips are together where the red playhead is set. The source mode plays the file selected in the navigation panel instead. Press space key to play and pause fast. Click on the first icon in the top right corner to see the preview in full screen mode. Press then escape key to exit. The tracks order is important. The video clips placed in higher tracks are the ones shown above others. You can change such order clicking and pulling up and down a track on the left. You can change the height of each track dragging the contours. The wider they are, the bigger the clip sample frames will show up. On top of a clip, a render bar may appear. Wait some time to have it completed. In this way, a clip is shown smoothly when you play a preview. You can add a new track clicking on the second icon from the left. You can rename a track, selecting it and clicking once on its name. You can delete a track, right-clicking on it. You can lock a track, clicking on the lock icon. A locked track can't be edited at all, unless you click again on the lock icon to unlock it. You have then the eye and the loudspeaker icons. The first one is used to hide and show all the visible clips inside the track. The second one to mute or not all sound clips inside the track instead. If you click on the levels icon, you can adjust better the audio and sound. If you are interested in video and sound effects, watch the related video in our guide. Let's see how to work with the timeline. You can move any clip, selecting it and dragging it throughout the same track or in another one. The pointer will come up as a white hand icon. Approach the edges and drag to change the duration of the clip. As long as the clip is text or an image, there aren't problems. But if you enlarge too much videos or sound files that do have a maximum duration, you may end up with red zones, indicating that you are stretching the clip with frames that show no motion or a flat waveform completely silent. If you approach the same edges more on top, you will add some fade transitions instead. Pay attention to the arrow direction of your pointer. If the arrow points outside the clip, You will adjust the clip's length. But if it points on the other way, you will edit the length of the time interval between the two following clips. You can use this, for example, to complete transitions. Use Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C, and Ctrl and V to cut, copy, and paste a selected clip. You can select more of them, holding Ctrl down and clicking on the interested clips. You can cut clips to delete them fast. You may need to split a clip in two parts at a certain instant of time. Just place the playhead correctly on the selected clip and press the end letter of your keyboard, or use the first button from the left on the center. Remember that you can undo any mistaken action pressing Ctrl and Z, or using the left arrow below File in the top left corner. Let's see how to move through your timeline quickly. If you use the mouse wheel, you will move the playhead. Hold down and use your mouse wheel to move vertically through your project. If you hold Ctrl down instead, you will zoom in and out horizontally. In case you have to do with complex projects, it is very useful having the navigator on top of the timeline, clicking on the third icon on the extreme left. By moving and stretching the rectangle on top, you can find and zoom the particular area you are interested in no time. Use the second icon to set the project settings. To learn how to export videos in HD, watch the related video in this guide. Last step is to save and export your project. To save it, just go to File and then to Save Movie As. In this way, you will save your project as a .axp file, in order to open and edit it in a second time. Otherwise, if you want to export and render your video, you need to click on Export in the top right corner. The following window, called Studio Exporter, shows you a final preview of your project on the center. You can decide where to export using Export Type. Under the preview, it is shown the space available left, and some other options depending on what chosen in export type. Choose simply File to export the video in your computer. Under Settings, you choose the format and the type. You can choose to save a snapshot or just audio parts of the project too. Check the preset details for the video resolution in output. You can then change the destination folder clicking on the folder icon under destination. When you are ready, click on Start Export. Obviously, depending on the export type chosen, the options can change a little. Thanks for watching this video. Check the following ones to discover more about Pinnacle Studio 17.